Good morning, students. Today we discuss the 8th lesson in our science textbook. Air, winds and cyclones. All of you students, take your textbook, page number 75. Now we discuss the in the 8th lesson effect of moving air. And wind, uneven heating on the earth. And uneven heating between the poles and the equator. Okay, students, all of you take your textbook, page number 79. Let us do eight. Take an incense stick. Take an incense stick, agarbatti, and light it. Observe the smoke of the incense stick. Observe the smoke produced from incense stick when we heat or light the incense stick or agarbatti. Okay. What does it go? This fumes of produced from incense stick rises up or goes up. That means the hot air or warm air moves upwards. Observation from the above activity indicate that hot air rises up. Also, it is important to remember that on heating, the air expand and occupy more space. On heating, the air expand and occupy more space. Heat air rises upwards and occupy more space and it expand. Air expand on heating. Air rises upward direction on heating. Air occupies large space on heating. Okay. When something occupies more space, it becomes less dense. If air occupies more space, its density is decreases. Density means mass per unit volume. It is called density. If air expands, its density is decreases. If any substance occupy more space, it has a lesser density. When something occupy more space, it becomes less dense. Less dense means less density. Density means mass per unit volume. The warm air is therefore less dense than the cold air. The warm air has a lesser density compared to the cold air. So the smoke and hot air goes up. The smoke released from produced from incense stick agarbatti and hot air always goes upward direction. Similar to observation activity done so far, numerous factors contribute to heat air when the air rises up. When we heat the air, that air rises up. And it has some pressure, air pressure at that place. Air exert pressure in all directions. Air exert pressure become low when we heat the air. It goes upwards and it has a less density. And air pressure at that place becomes low. And we have many kinds of winds. The air comes to occupy areas of low pressure area. So the air always moves from higher, lower pressure, higher pressure area to lower pressure area. Lower pressure area in cyclone's time. In cyclone's time, air moves, air blows very fast from lower pressure region to higher pressure region. Higher pressure region. The differential heating of land. The differential heating of land or on land and water by the sun leads to land and sea breeze. Leads to land and sea breeze due to sun heat. Sun heat the land surface and also seas and oceans create land and sea breeze. Land and sea breeze. Okay, now see this diagrams. See the diagrams. Forms clouds also. Clouds also. Okay, the land heat up faster than seas and the oceans. The land heat up very faster than the seas or oceans. To warm air rises over the land during the day as it warmed by the sun. Okay, during the land warm up or heated up during the heated by sun, the air rages up and it flows throughout the land on the surface of earth and this air reaches the seas and ocean areas. It again cools down forms this air forms the sea breeze, that is called sea breeze. The land heats up faster than the sea or ocean. So the warm air rages over the land during the day as it is warmed by sun's heat. Okay. At a certain time of year, this can create a sea breeze. This warmed air rages up and moves or blows entire Earth planet. We know the Earth contains 78% of water. 78% of water. This air reaches the seas and ocean bodies, water bodies, converted into sea breeze at the surface of seas and oceans. At certain time of year, this can create a sea breeze, which is a gentle breeze blowing into the land. Again, this sea breeze and blows into the land. At night, the land cools faster than the sea. At daytime, the land heated up very fast than seas and oceans. At night time, the land cools very faster than seas and oceans, reversing the air flow. At night, reversing the air flow. Daytime air flow from land to seas and ocean surfaces. And night time, the air blows from seas and ocean surface to land. The reversing process. This creates a land breeze that blows out to sea. This create a land breeze. They can create a sea breeze. Sea breeze or ocean breeze also. Night time create a land breeze. Let us do 9. Effect of moving air. Effect of moving air. Take a glass and a postcard. This is a postcard. This is an empty glass. Empty glass. This is a postcard. Place the postcard on this empty glass. Now take another postcard or another small notebook and move this notebook on the surface of and above the surface of postcard very quickly. The air also moves faster on the above the surface of this postcard. We observe the movement of postcard present on the mouth of the glass jar. That means That means effect of moving air. This is the moving air. We create the moving air with another notebook. Another notebook. We move the notebook. So the postcard will move on the mouth of the glass jar or mouth of the glass. Take a glass on a postcard. Keep the glass on a table and the postcard on the glass. This postcard place on the glass. Postcard place on the glass. Wave your hand or notebook above the postcard. Wave, create a wave and move very quickly on the above the surface of postcard. Above the surface of postcard. To displace the air just above the postcard. To displace the air just above the postcard. So this is, that means effect of moving, that means effect of moving air. Moving air displaces the postcard. Postcard. What do you observe? Why did postcard lift up? Why did the postcard lift up? Lift up. Above the surface of postcard create a lower pressure. Inside the glass jar contain air, this air has a high pressure. The high pressure air occupies this low pressure region, low pressure area. Low pressure area. So this inside the air inside the glass jar moves or flow to the mouth of the glass jar. Mouth of the glass jar. The postcard automatically moves or fall down or fell down. Okay. Now wet the edges of glass with water. Now wet the edges of glass with water. Stick the postcard to it. Here, stick the postcard to it. Edges of this glass with water. Edges of the water, glass with water. So, stick the postcard at the mouth of this glass jar. Mouth of this glass jar. Now wet the edges of glass with water. Wet means moisture cheyali. Mouth of the glass jar ne moisture chesam. Water to. And moisture chase mouth of the glass jar in post guard stick chase glass jar invert chase in chum. Invert chase a launchum. Hand to patuna. Hold chase in chum. And another hand to post guard the same moves very quickly, very fastly. Bottom of the post guard. Now wet the edges of the glass with the water, stick the post guard to it and hold it inverted. And hold it inverted. Hold it inverted with your left hand, I shown figure, and move your right hand or notebook to move the air from under the paper. To move air under the paper. This indicates the air under the paper. You can imagine what would happen. Have you ever seen high speed wind blowing over the roof of a house? High speed blowing air blows up the roofs, thatched roofs in cyclone days. Cyclone వచ్చేది అప్పుడు thatched roofs ఆ రేకులు ఉన్న హౌసెస్ అవన్నీ బ్లోస్ అయిపోతాయి చూడండి పై దగ్గర పడిపోతాయి. రీజన్ ఏంటంటే the air moves fast parallel to the any surface of body create lower pressure. Inside the body has a inside the contained air, it has a high pressure. This high pressure air try to occupy the low pressure region. That's why the thatched roof blows out. Thatched roof blows out. If roof were weak, they could be lifted and blown away. Lifted and blown away. If you have heard or seen any such experiences, share it with our friends. So, my cyclone days lo, mere appudu observe chestu untaru. Cyclone days lo. In activity 9, when we move our hand, there is a movement of air caused. When we move our hand, there is a movement of air. Air is caused. So the moving air creates low pressure. This moving air creates low pressure under the postcard. Under the postcard. Moving air creates a lower pressure under the postcard. Under the postcard. The glass jar contains air, this air has a high pressure. Has a high pressure. This high pressure air try to occupy this lower pressure region below the post guard, below the post guard. That's why the post guard will fell down. Yes, the paper lift up due to the high pressure on the paper from air in the glass. When on the other hand, we hold the glass facing down, this activity, facing down, the same thing happened and the air inside the glass pushes, air inside the glass pushes the paper or postcard out and make the paper fall down. Here also the air inside the glass jar moves up because above the surface of postcard create lower pressure. Inside the air of glass jar try to occupy the low pressure region. That's why the postcard will move in first activity. Wind and uneven heating on the earth. Wind uneven heating on the earth. Second one. Okay, we have discussed the cause of the wind in areas near large water bodies. Large water bodies means seas and oceans. Seas and oceans are called large water bodies. What about wind on the other parts of the earth? What about wind on the other part of the earth? The wind always blows entire over the earth planet, on the surface of earth planet. We know moving air called wind. Moving air is called wind. Okay. What are the reasons that different areas have different temperatures? What are the reasons of different areas have different temperatures? Because wind breeze and sea breeze, and because hot air and cold air moves over the surface of the earth. Let us try to find more about all these. Uneven heating take place on the surface of the earth. Uneven heating take place on the surface of earth. Therefore, the number of reasons for this. First reason is global warming. So, uneven heating between the equator and the poles. You might have learned in a geography that the region close to the equator get more heat from the sun. We know the equator has more heat from the sun. This is because the direction of equator absorbs the more heat from the sun. This is because absorption of sunlight being straight, very straighter. Absorption of sunlight from sun, it being straighter close to the equator. The air in this region get warmer very fast. The air in the equator regions get warmer or heated up very fast. The warm air rages up. And the colder air from the regions in 0 to 30 degrees latitude belt on either side of the equator. So the warm air at the equator rages up, create lower pressure at equator. The either side of the equator has a polar air, temperature between 0 degree to 30 degrees. That cool air blows from either side of the equator to middle of the equator. Here the cool air moves from higher pressure region to lower pressure region. This movement of air set forth winds, and forth means moves forward direction. Air moves forward direction. This movement of air sets forth winds. Forth winds means move forward direction. Wind move forward direction that move over the earth. This cool air moves over the earth. What are the earth? Surface of the earth. So we also see that the increased wind speed. Increased wind speed. When air moves from higher region to lower region, higher pressure region to lower pressure region, it moves very fastly. The moving air is called wind. The moving air is called wind. You might have seen in 6th class about how winds are produced, how they are bring rain, how winds are produced, how bring rain. Now let us understand how winds and rain can be destructive sometimes. Okay, students, we will learn in the next class uneven heating, land and water, and cyclone, and how cyclone may form. We will learn in the next class. Okay, thank you.